الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. We praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Him to help us and assist us and forgive us and protect us from the evil of ourselves and the sins that we do. Indeed, whosoever Allah guides, no one can lead astray. And whosoever Allah leads astray, no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah alone, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the worst of religious matters are those that are innovated. And every religious innovation is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is misguidance, and every misguidance will be in hellfire. What does it mean to be thankful? And why should we be thankful? That attribute or quality of thankfulness is first of all an attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal. A name of Allah is Ash-Shakir and Ash-Shakur, the thankful, the one whom, when people worship Him, rewards them abundantly, more than what they deserve, a lot more than what they deserve. Even when they do a little bit, Allah Azza wa Jalla never forgets it. This is an attribute and a quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah also wants it to be a quality of humanity, a quality of the believers. Because in contrast to shukr, stands at the other end, kufr. And kufr, if you want to understand it at the very basic level, is a lack of thankfulness. It could be a small type of kufr where the person does not recognize the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal, does not use the blessings of Allah the way that Allah wants them to, but eventually can graduate into a major kufr where the person associates others with Allah Azza wa Jal when he wants to thank, or stops altogether thanking Allah for these blessings. Allah says, أَنِشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Thank me, but do not respond with kufr. To contrast shukr to kufr. And that is, kufr is really the lack of shukr, and shukr is the opposite of kufr. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. He says, if you're gonna disbelieve, if you're gonna do kufr, Allah does not need you. He's self-sufficient, does not need anybody, but He is not pleased when you commit kufr. But He says, وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. But if you thank Allah, He'll be happy with you. So thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is iman, is escaping from disbelief. And that is probably the way that disbelief starts, where people start rejecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that they forget about thanking Him. Forget about all the reasons why they should thanking Him. forget about the ni'mas that Allah gives to them. The ni'mas that they're enjoying at this particular moment, they only focus on the negative. What is wrong with their lives and what is wrong with this world, and so they graduate from a discontentment that is personal to a discontentment that is general to a discontentment with the Creator, and ultimately people start denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because the only thing that they can see is the negative. And they don't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what they have. And Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that one of the plots of the shaitan is to stand between you and thankfulness. To be really grateful. Because the shaitan promised, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ I'm going to go and attack them. From the front and the back. وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ And from the right and from the left. Meaning from every possible direction. Then he says, وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ And you're not going to find that most of them are going to be thankful. That this is a plan from the shaitan recorded in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal that we all could read and keep reading to understand what he's trying to do. He says, I'm going to surround them from every direction so that they don't thank you. They don't recognize whatever you have given them. They do not appreciate it and they do not thank you. وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ So you can understand that a person who wants to be closer to Allah will thank Allah more and will see the beauty behind what Allah is doing and what He had given to him. And the person who's following the shaitan will grow more and more thankless, not seeing any benefit, any favor in his life from Allah Azza wa Jal, but constantly looking at what is negative and what is wrong with their lives. And that is one of the things, as I said, the shaitan tries to do. If Allah Azza wa Jal, as some of the pious predecessors have said, He said the shaitan will come to you after Allah Azza wa Jal had saved you from something. Saved you from harm, took it away from you. And he will try to play down, belittle the favor of Allah by saying, well, it wasn't that big of a deal. It wasn't really that serious. It would have gone by itself so that you will stop thanking Allah and being grateful for the great that he had done you. But rather he should say to himself, that man, that pious man is saying, but rather you should counter these types of thoughts by saying, it could have been a lot worse, but Allah saved me from it. But here the shaitan is trying to stop you from thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and wants to blind you. And the difficulty here is that we also have this tendency in us not to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, not to thank in general. So Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran in more than ayah that this is in fact is gonna be the attitude of humanity. وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ Few among my servants are truly thankful. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ But most people do not thank. And here before we proceed, subhanAllah, I want you to think about it that if Allah Azza wa Jal is saying that few people only thank Him. And He is the one who had given us everything. But only few will thank Him. Don't be surprised if people do not thank you. If you do something to help and people are less than thankful, grateful, or not thankful at all, or they forget about what you've done, don't be surprised, because if they have done that with Allah Azza wa Jal, why would they not do that with you? So don't expect people really to be grateful and thankful and appreciative all the time. They don't do it with the Almighty. They're not going to do it with you. But we have this tendency within us not to thank. Most of us, Allah says, most of humanity are not thankful. They don't see the ni'mas of Allah and they do not thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has given them. And in this timeless wisdom, this is built within us, there's timeless wisdom of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he said, لَوْ كَانَ لِبْنِ آدَمَ وَادٍ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ لَبْتَغَ وَادِيًا He says, if the child of Adam has a valley's fill of gold, he will seek the second. So there is this something with us, within us, plus modern culture. What is within us is that whatever you give us, we constantly become dissatisfied with it. And we start looking towards the next thing, and the next thing, and the next thing. We don't pause, we don't appreciate what Allah has given us, what we have. But rather, as soon as we get it, and this is the greed that we have built within us. Part of our DNA is greed that we have to fight. If we have one valley full of gold, more than what you ever need, you're not going to even be able to spend that. You're not going to stop there. You want the second valley. And if you have the second valley, you want a third valley of gold, and so on and so on and so on, in an appetite that will never be filled until death. So we have that within us. We look always at what we don't have, not what we have. But also modern culture as well has taught us this very well. Had taught us to be dissatisfied with whatever we have, because as soon as we get it, they tell you, look at the other thing, buy the next thing. So we get, but our happiness with what we receive is short-lived. And again, we have not taught ourselves to be appreciative, to thank Allah Azza wa Jal for the little things that we have. And so we grow more and more upset and angry and dissatisfied with our lives, with what we have lost, with what we have missed. But in fact, you find that Allah Azza wa Jal had tied iman to shukr and shukr to iman. That is, if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should be aware of all the ni'mas that He had given you. You should take the time to count these ni'mas and thank Allah Azza wa Jal for them. From the ni'mas that are small to the ni'mas that are big. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Allah Azza wa Jal says that in the creation of the heavens and the earth and the alternation of day and night are signs for those who have minds. الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض. Those who remember Allah constantly standing, sitting and on their sides, and they contemplate, ponder the creation this universe. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ. Ya Allah, you did not create this for nothing. Meaning that those who believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla are not blind to what is around them. They see the great ni'mas of Allah, His power and everything, His wisdom and everything, and they thank Allah for it. وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَهُ لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. It is He, Allah Azza wa Jalla, who had made the night and day to alternate so that you will have an opportunity in them to remember and be thankful. And this means two things. One, that when they alternate, you can thank Allah in the morning and in the evening. Remember Him in the morning and in the evening. And also it means that the passage of time, when you look at it, will cause you to remember Allah Azza wa Jal and remember His power and remember His blessing. So just the mere observation of things that are around you, summer and winter, fall and spring, that in itself is a ni'mah from Allah Azza wa Jal. The stars, the sky, the sun and the moon, ni'mah from Allah Azza wa Jal. The family that you have around you, ni'mah from Allah Azza wa Jal. The ability to eat, the ability to drink, health, safety, ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of these things that are small and that are big require a pause. Meaning I should take the time to just simply slow down and not so completely be in a hurry, in a rush, dissatisfied, but pause and sit and say, let me look at the ni'mas around me, where I am. The ni'mas in my parents, the ni'mas in my spouse, the ni'mah in my children, the ni'mah in my house, the ni'mah in my vehicle, the ni'mah in this, the ni'mah in that. and start saying Alhamdulillah for this, Alhamdulillah for this, and make it a habit to repeat the praise and the thank of Allah Azza wa Jal often. Alhamdulillah for this, I thank Allah for this, I praise Allah for this. And you will notice a transformation within you, because now you can see what you are missing. You can see the blessing in Allah Azza wa Jal surrounding you, even in the smallest of things. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once when he went out from his home hungry, and he met Abu Bakr and he met Umar, and all of them were hungry, and he went and they were hosted by another Sahabi, an Ansari, and he gave them some dates to eat, and he gave them some cold water, and they were sitting in the shade. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these three things that you've just got, that shade, the cold water, and the dates, are from the na'im, are from the blessings that Allah will ask you about on the Day of Judgment. That is, this is a ni'mah. This is a ni'mah. Take the time to actually, when you sit, and you're sitting comfortably, and you eat something, it doesn't need to be expensive or fancy, but you eat something, and you can eat, and you can digest, and you drink sips of cold water, and you say, Alhamdulillah for this, because I may not have enjoyed it otherwise. Alhamdulillah that Allah made it possible. And you will see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change your heart and change your life because of it. This is from the na'im that Allah will ask you about. Did you thank it? Something as small as this. You say, I don't have. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه معافا في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها. He says, if you wake up in the morning and you are safe and sound, you're not afraid, and you're healthy, and you have enough to eat for your day, it says, as if this entire world has been wrapped and given to you. As if you're a king on this earth, because everything that a king may possess boils down to these three things. Anything else is extra. You think about it. You need safety. Now, when you woke up today, were you safe? Were somebody after you? Did you feel secure? Why not then ask Allah Azza wa Jal, or thank Him for this ni'mah? Alhamdulillah that this is the case. Alhamdulillah. Why am I saying Alhamdulillah? Because I want that ni'mah to be preserved, to be protected. I don't want it to go away. Alhamdulillah, I want to keep seeing it day after day. So Alhamdulillah for this. And you woke up today and you're healthy. Or let's say at least mostly healthy. You're not in the hospital. Shouldn't I thank Allah Azza wa Jal for this? Rather than say, why did I wake up? For what reason did I wake up? Rather than complain, just recognize there is no pain in this arm or this leg or that leg or in my head. I woke up and I'm healthy. Alhamdulillah. It could have been a lot worse, but Allah had given me health today. And then you have enough to eat. Your fridge is full, alhamdulillah. Or you have enough money, you can go and you can buy food. You're not panicking because you have to feed your kids, because you have to feed your family. No, you have enough. Isn't this a ni'mah? And if you start saying Alhamdulillah to all of this, it will bring you a lot of peace of mind and peace inside your heart and satisfaction that can never happen until you start thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. We are blind to the ni'mas of Allah around us. So we need to start rediscovering them. And you start rediscovering them by start saying Alhamdulillah. And now start looking for, what should I thank Allah Azza wa Jal for? قول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وأصلي وأسلم على رسوله محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And a person may say, well, I'm going through very difficult times. How and can I thank Allah Azza wa Jal during these times too? And we say that it all depends on how you look at it and all depends on how you interpret these rough times. If you ask yourself, no matter what you're going through, could it be worse? And that is a pivotal point in you recognizing the ni'mah of Allah upon you, even when times are rough. Ask yourself, could it be worse? And if you say to yourself, yes, I could imagine it being a lot worse, then recognize what Allah had saved you from. Recognize how Allah is merciful with you and with me, how He is latif, gentle with you and me, even when we are being tested, that Allah Azza wa Jalla is also yet and never stops being kind. Could it be worse? Yes, it could be a lot worse. I could be suffering a lot more. And now your heart will start recognizing, yes, there is this area that I should thank Allah for more because it could get a lot worse. Then ask yourself, is there benefit behind this problem? As much as I'm in pain, as much as I want to go for it to go away, and I pray that it goes away, but there could there be a benefit behind it? And there might be worldly benefit behind it that you and I cannot see. So we'll leave that, trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that while that will be revealed at the right time. But if you think about it, is Allah Azza wa Jalla, if I become patient, will Allah take away my sins because of this trouble? And if the answer is yes, you start seeing that Allah Azza wa Jalla is cleansing you through it. And if you were to be given the choice, like that pious sahabiyya at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was sick, and the Prophet gave her the option, I can make dua for you and you will be well, or you go to Jannah if you endure and you be patient. And she said, I'll be patient. That is, if it is an exchange between being in pain in this life, but knowing that Allah with every moment is taking away a sin of yours and is bringing you closer to Jannah, would you exchange that for happiness here? But then when you meet Allah Azza wa Jalla, you'll be in debt because of all the bad things you and I have done, and Allah will tell you, no, you have to spend some time in Jahannam. Would you take that instead of some pain here? So if you think about it, that little pain, which does not compare to being burned in hellfire, that little pain right here is actually helping you and me. Is actually saving you and me from a lot of harm. So then you can start saying, maybe I can start thanking Allah Azza wa Jalla for this. Even though it's difficult, I can start thanking Allah because I know that when He makes a choice, His choice is the best choice. And if you start now thinking about what Allah will grant you in Jannah, He'll grant me this beautiful thing and this beautiful that, then you'll say, whatever pain I go through, whatever, whether it's brief or long, is worth it. So you start thanking Allah Azza wa Jalla not only for the so-called bounties, but also the difficulties, whatever Allah Azza wa Jalla gives. You'll start being a thankful servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single time. And you ask yourself, well, how do I do this? You say, I do this by first recognizing that it's important. Recognize it, that it is actually part of my iman, not irrelevant to it. Part of my iman, it preserves it. Recognize it, that it repels the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jal. Recognize that if I want it, I need to seek it. And part of seeking it is asking Allah for it. Part of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَجْعَلْنِي لَكَ شَكَّارًا. Ya Allah, make me a very thankful person. لَكَ ذَكَّارًا, remembering you often. So Ya Allah, make me a thankful person. And part of the dua that we say, that we are taught, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught, Allahumma inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Ya Allah, assist me to remember you and to thank you and to worship you well. And here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam combining these three, remembering Allah,
and thanking Allah and the good worship of Allah, he joins them together because they are connected. You do not thank Allah until you remember Him. And if you remember Allah well, you will thank Him. And you're not going to be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala well until you are a thankful person. So we magnify the negative in our lives. We harp on it. But if you become thankful for the past and the present, you're not going to worry about the future. Your anxiety about the future, inshallah, will evaporate. Because you are filled with what? Satisfaction. Meaning that tomorrow, like today and yesterday, whatever Allah gives me is good and I'll thank Him for it. You'll not be afraid. And rather than regret the past, this mistake and that mistake and this person did that to me or said that to me. Rather than this, knowing that Allah Azza wa Jal put it there for a good reason, so thank Allah Azza wa Jal for that experience. And thank Allah so that He can teach you from it and with it, then that bad experience also evaporates. And whatever remains is gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal. Gratitude for the things that He gives, but also gratitude for the things that He does not give. So thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will keep blessing you. And His blessings will keep increasing and increasing, and you will feel better on the inside. And you'll be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah Rabbil Alameen, Ya Allah, make us of the thankful who remember You often, all the time, and thank You often and all the time. We ask You, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to allow us to thank You for all Your ni'mas. Allow us to thank You for Your religious ni'mas and for Your worldly ni'mas. Allow us to thank You for Your major ni'mas and the minor ni'mas. Allow us to thank You and thank the people around us who are vehicles in delivering these blessings to us. Allow us, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to always recognize Your blessings and not be trapped by our difficulties. Allow us, Ya Rabbil Alameen, a repentance that cleanses internally and externally. Allow us, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to rush back to You and accept us, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Accept our dua, accept our forgiveness, accept us in Jannah and protect us from hellfire. Protect us and our spouses and our children and our families from hellfire, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. And grant us and the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heaven. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونسألك الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونسألك من خير ما سألك عبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه عبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر والله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر والله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا واعتدلوا تراصوا straighten your rows close the gaps يرحمني وإياكم الله. Complete your lines and do not leave gaps in them.
Allahu Akbar.
Subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Tabaraka ismuka wa ta'ala jaddaka la ilaha illa anta. A'udhu billahi as-sami'il 'alim minash shaitani r-rajim.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil 'alamin. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سبحان الله العظيم الله أكبر
تحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات السلام على النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام عليكم صلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد صليت على علي وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد باركت على علي وبارك في العالمين انك حميد مجيد اللهم انا نعوذ بك من عذاب النار فتنة المحيا والممات من شر فتنة المسيح الدجال فاني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Allahumma anta as-salam, minka as-salam, tabarakatuk.
Assalamu alaikum, ikhwani. We have regular halaqa every Friday after Maghrib by Sheikh Ali, our khatib today. So very important, bring you and your family, inshallah, to learn the deen of Allah. Dalinyarada halakena, ikhwani, jam'ada, ya ahad walba halakada, dalinyarada halakeno. Also, don't forget to donate the house of Allah, ikhwani, donate something. Also, please respect the neighbor.